Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Pillars of Eternity. It's been a while, hasn't it? About exactly 1 week since the last episode, and I apologize for this very long delay. It's just that I have been rather busy lately, mostly with school. I have had some exams, some little school projects I still need to do and finish, and there's still going to be one more exam at least, and a couple of little things I need to do before the summer starts and school ends and stuff like that. So yeah, that's why I've been busy. Oh, and I also didn't have any electricity in my apartment for a couple of days or so, that's why I also couldn't do anything even if I wanted to. But hey, I'm back now, and that's what matters, right? I'm back, baby. But anyway, let's see what were we planning to do this time? I kind of forgot what my plan was. So let's see. Never far from the queen. All right. Go to Temple of Void Digger. Oh yeah. It's that temple in ruins. Which is actually right next to this keep. Let's see. Oh yeah, this quest. Travel to Anglo's Compass. Oh yeah, this was Commander Cliver's Fortnite seemed to have been a success. In fact, the High Justice wants to expand by having his own Forge Masters build Fortnite at Fleetbreaker Castle. Commander Cliver asked me to deliver the research to one of the High Justice's commanders at Anslög's Compass, and we know where that is. That is that place where I forgot the Aumua woman's name, but yeah, she's there, along with the Xorip, which we also killed for her. So yeah, she's on that coast. The Child of the Five Sun. This is the Palaginas quest. God, I love Palaginas. She's so fucking cool. Anyway, help Palatina broker a trade agreement with the Anamifad in Twin Elms. That's very far away, so we're not gonna go there for a while. The Long Hunt, that's Sagani's quest. The Master Below, oh yeah, this is a Kite Nua thingy. Time and Tide, Kana's quest, Durance's quest, and Eder's quest. Little task, missing sentries. Oh yeah, this is the Heritage Hill quest. I think we could go and do this after we have went to Anglos's Compass. Yeah, that sounds like a plan to me. And what's this? The Parable of Whale. Oh yeah, this is the one quest from the archives where we have to go and retrieve the scroll back some thieves stole from the library. But that's in Hetkinen. It's in Deerwood, alright, and that's quite far away as well. Yeah, it's here, and Twill Elms is even further away here, but Anslög's Compass is here, so I say we go there first. Yeah, let's do that. So yeah, again, I really apologize for this long delay. But hey, real life, so what can I do? But anyway, like I said, there's still going to be at least one exam next week, and I still need to finish a few small things before this semester ends and the summertime starts and stuff like that. But I would dare to say that the worst is over. So I can come back and make these videos again. In a steady rhythm. All right. So first we can just go this way, and then we go here, right? Like this. Damn, I'm so smart. And it takes 1 day, 24 hours, and 30 minutes. So basically 2 days and 30 minutes. I don't know why it says 1 day and 24 hours and 30 minutes, but whatever. South Curtain wall construction completed. All right, let's take care of this real fast. What to build next? Well, I guess we should also build the West Curtain wall to get more security. Now, let's meet Aranroid by the dock. There was a dock here. Oh, this one. This little dock here. But something tells me that this is not going to be that easy to do that. That we just find a guy and give the papers and there it's done. Something tells me that something's going to happen. You there, did Commander Cliver send you? Yes, indeed he did.
Greetings.
The woman sizes you up, squinting against the glare from the water. You have come from the Crucible Keep, I take it. I was told you would have something for me. Kifiona's riches, here it is. Tell me about what's happening at Fleetbreaker Castle. Might as well ask. Her eyes narrow, but she eventually shrugs. You're obviously helping Commander Cliver, so I suppose I can tell you. The High Justice has been gathering forces there. This mess with the legacy, the unrest and the man-eating corpses all over the Deerwood. It isn't going away anytime soon, and the dozens are using this as an opportunity for a power grab. She straightens. We have got to build up in strength to defend the Deerwood as well as our position here. And with these fortunates at our disposal, we'll be unstoppable. Well, good for you. Here's the research. Excellent. I should get this back to the High Justice before. She looks over your shoulder at a sound of approaching footsteps. Too late. Get ready. Yeah, I knew it. Look at these peasants. They look so cute, trying to look that menacing and threatening and all. This man's face is twisted into a snarl. Are you mad? You hold the secrets to one of the foulest examples of animality, and you want to hand it over to the Crucible Knights? Well, I don't really care what you think about them, though. He shakes his head. It's an abomination. Caged souls used as weapons, and you would give these silk stockings an army of them? He raises his axe to tighten his grip around the haft. I can't let you do this. The research must be destroyed. I would like to see you try. I'll destroy you. You'll have to get through me first. Oh, if we were a monk, we would have our own special dialogue option here. Cool. I would like to see you try, or I'll destroy you. I would like to see you try. Kill them all. Yeah, indeed. I would like to see you try, bitch. I think that Palatina should go and try to fuck that guy up. And Eder, I want you to go and tank those guys. Go and punch him in the face. And I want you to buff everyone. You use your spell somewhere around here. And marked prey. Let's mark this one and then send the wolf attack this him. And let's go somewhere around here. This should be good. Alright, and then let's use this spell. This is so badass and it hurts a lot. Somewhere around here should be good. Let's just hope that it doesn't damage our friends. So far so good. They are dropping like flies. They are dropping like flies. And then we go and attack. Looks like that wizard there made some mirror images of himself. Palatina, go and fuck this guy up. Holy crap! One hit! Holy crap, they are so weak. Just one hit, and that guy lost over half of his health. Jesus Christ. Knock this guy over. Oh wait, you're there. Yeah, well, probably I can take care of her. Or him. Oh wait, he's dead already, never mind. And shoot this one. Come on. There we go. Piece of cake. Aranroid wipes her blade on the lining of her cape. I'll take that as our cue to leave. With the dozens growing so bold, there's no time to waste. She strides back toward the waiting boat. Give my regards to the commander, and watch your back out here. So there could possibly be more of them in this on this coast. And return to Crucible Keep. Yep. Interesting looking shield. But let's see if it's any better than what we already have. Right. Yep, loot
just
everyone.
Just say the word.
Loot everyone. Let's see if this grimoire has anything interesting on it. Now then. Shield of Fuck. Spirit Shield. Mirrored Image. So this was the spell what he used there earlier. Creates duplicates of the caster to distract enemies, granting high deflection bonus, which is reduced with each hit taken. Interesting. Runecream's Repulsive Visage. The caster's face becomes a nightmarish mask of rotting insect-infested flesh or other images of unspeakable horror, compelling all nearby foes to become terrified and sickened. And this is... creates a ball of energy in the caster's hand that can be thrown at an enemy, causing burn, freeze, corrode, or shock damage to anyone caught in the area of effect. Blights are continually replenished until the spell ends. That sounds very badass too. I actually like both these two, the mirror images and this spell. So, let's learn... let's learn all of this. Nice. And now, let's see, is this shield any better than what we are having, that we have now? How did you... How did I compare my... items again. Wait, no. Been such a long time since I played this game that I have forgotten how to do even the most simple things like comparing the items. Well, I guess I have to just do it this way. Yeah, it's the exact same. All right. Shame. Anything else we got there that could interest us? Oh yeah, we got also this armor. I'm still holding on to it. Nothing else here. Also, although 15 to 22, and this does 10, 15. Yeah. All right. I think we. That's
just
it.
Say
that's
the word.
Everything. And now I was thinking. I was just thinking here that before we go to Crucible Keep, we should go and check out Heritage Hill first. Yeah, that sounds like a plan to me. So, first let's go to Copper Lane. We go there and have a rest. And then we go to Heritage Hill to find out what's going on there. Although I'm quite sure that it's infested with undead, zombies, skeletons, whatever, that kind of stuff. We go and clear that place, and I think we had to find some patrol. Missing sentries. Willa, a justiciar in the Crucible Knight has had several of her novitiates standing guard outside Heritage Hill go missing under mysterious circumstances. All right, so yeah, I assume that I'm have to find them. Wait, does this game pause every time I do this? Yes, it does. Damn it! I thought these characters would still be running even if I look at my inventory. Well, whatever. And something also tells me that we also have to deal with the Domino family some more in the future.
Hail and well met.
Yeah, I want a room, and I guess I could sleep in a more fancy one this time, just so I can get some extra bonuses for the Heritage Hill. Let's see, what could we use most? This might actually be very nice. Well, let's sleep in here. Fletcher's stay. At least Sagane will be getting some nice bonuses, like five 5 more accuracy or something along those lines, if I read it correctly. But yeah, we are most likely have to deal with Domino family again. And actually, in the last episode, we did have an encounter with the Domino family's thugs, but we didn't really do anything to them. We just let them do whatever they wanted to that poor merchant. But because we are such a-holes, we didn't care and just let the Dominals tux do whatever they wanted to him. Oh, and I should put the fast mode on. Makes things a lot faster. All right, so I guess we have to go to first fires first, and then from there to Heritage Hill. Fine. And then here. Yeah, Heritage Hill is there. Well, at least they are moving while I'm looking at the map.
And a shrine to Margaret as well. Her clergy belongs there.
Yeah, alright, whatever you say, Durance. And to Heritage Hill we go. Let's see, what do we have here? Best turn around, traveler. Heritage Hill is... Sorry, dude, I missed that. Heritage Hill is closed, but I got a permission to go there.
Hail, traveler.
The guard holds up a palm. Sorry, but this district's closed by order of the Duke himself. Willa sent me. I'm looking into the missing guards. Might 18. Let me in, or whatever's on the other side of that gate will be the least of your problems. Yeah, let's do that. Take it easy, he looked at the other guard. Look, it's your neck. Don't say we didn't warn you. He turns and unlocks the gate. Yeah. Now, find the missing guards.
Please get my...
Holy crap. Yeah, there really are skeletons. Skeletal fighters, rangers, and wizards. Lovely. Alright, so let's mark this one. And then the wolf attacks that one. And Paulagina, I think you should go there as well. In the meanwhile, there you focus on that one. You focus on that one as well. And I guess you could use a spell there as well, assuming that you can cast spells through this gate. You should be able to at least.
I bloody...
Or maybe not. God damn it! Well, cast a spell here. Excuse me. Just attack this ranger here. Knock this one down. Oh wait, there was another one, I didn't notice. Come on, Paladina, fuck him up. With your holy fire. There we go. And I think that was
yeah.
It. Yeah. See, simple skeletons. They are not much of a threat. A rod. Is it any better than our scepter? Doesn't look like it, no. And we got lots of bones. Nice.
Can do.
Although I'm quite sure that those bones are useless because they are marked as... Where are the bones? I was just wondering whether they are crafting materials. Oh, there we go, vessel bone. Oh yeah, they must be crafting materials. And we got camping supplies. Although, do we have maximum mount? Yes, we do. But we also got tanglefoot trap. I actually want to give all the traps to Zagani now that I think about it. Where are my traps? There is one trap, and there's also these minor entrance and scrolling flame spell. Those are also nice to have. But yeah, I guess that was all of my traps. Oh yeah, Winky has all the had all the other traps. And what's this? Rite of the Untamed Wild. Not sure, but I think we should give these to... Not this one. To you. Since you are a healer and everything anyway. And I give this to you. And you can have this. Yep.
Just say the word.
Oh yeah, we already looted that. Something twitches and shambles in the darkness between the slats. A rutted draft creeps from the house. But we can't enter there, alright. What about here? Anything in? I can hear some more footsteps. There are more skeletons nearby.
I can do that.
Oh shit.
That's settled.
Well, at least we unlocked that. Darkul. That's someone special, I take it.
I'm ready.
Well, Jesus Christ, he's taking a lot of damage. And here I thought that he would fall down instantly. Knock it down one more time. There we go. That must have been someone important.
Hey.
No one important enough to carry any treasures or something apparently. And here we got lots of gold and balloon. What's this? Ah, it's a fruit. I take it. It's gemstones. Yeah, all right. So crafting materials basically. These vaults have already been pried open. And there's some more Kickstarter backers' names in here, if I'm not mistaken, so I'm not gonna bother to check those. Oh, ghouls. Oh, crap. Lots of ghouls. I kind of miss Winky now, because if only I could scout a bit more here, that would be nice. But then again, maybe I could use Sagani for scouting. She should be rather good at stealth. Heal up, apology. Yeah, these guys are weak. Alright, we got flesh and
a simple test.
Lockpicks required 3, party lockpicks 5. Do you want to pick the lock? Well, let's take a risk.
That's settled.
There must be something good there. Oh, spell award amulet plus 10 defense against spells. That's very good find, and we got some gold as well. Wait, what? Golden duck value 12 copper. This golden duck is the only gold coin minted in the Direwood. They bear the faces of historical ducks of the Deerwood, though most of them show the face of the first duck, Admet Hutred. So wait, there's 60 of them, and it's only 12, and it's only valued. It's only 12 copper. Well, that's fucking weird. Anyway, who doesn't have an amulet of any kind? You don't really have anything, so I guess I could give this to you then. Oh, and let's see, what are your stats? Stealth 4, so it's not as good at stealthing as in Winky, but it's better than the rest of these guys, I think.
Just say the word.
What about here? The crosshatch claw marks a score this vault. All right. And more ghouls. And skeleton dark ghouls. Oh wait. Oh, Darkul wasn't a named guy. All right, it's a creature. All right, fine. Knock that one over, and I think it's I think it's best that we buff everyone here.
Hey.
Could you knock this dark ghoul over? Or not. Mark this one if you can, and send Itumak there as well. But then again, everyone is in Itumak's way, so he can't, whatever. Alright, let's use one of these scroll thingies. Oh wait, what did it do again? Requires... Oh wait, what? 13.4 endurance, so it should be healing. Well, heal yourself. And use your holy fire on that door. And now everyone gang up on upon him. I don't want to use any of your spells.
Yeah.
And one more time. There we go. And more
can do.
Vessel flesh. And some burnt ladies. Unlocking this will require the proper key. All
just
right.
Say the word.
Guess we have to look for a key for that then.
A small
plague at the base reads freedom above all, admin hatred.
Just say the word.
Mm-hmm. There's a crypt there where we could also go. Oh, look at this fancy hat. Duelist's hat. Hats come in many different shapes, sizes, and a wide variety of colors. Dyewoodens are known for their modest, rustic hats, while Valians are associated with broad-brimmed hats featuring a variety of exotic plumes. Alright, nice. Whom should we give this fabulous hat to? Let's see. Where is it? Or is it here somewhere? There it is. Alright. Let's see, what does he look like? He looks so fabulous. Although, I kinda hate the fact how he looks like he's bald. I'd rather have his hair shown. What about... Oh yeah, Palagina is a godlike, so she can't wear helmets of any kind. Even though she doesn't really have any horns or any other mutations or anything growing out of her head besides those feathers, so logically she should be able to wear this hat, but she can't, which is a great shame because she would look so fabulous with this. I just want to see what this looks like on me. She looks kind of funny, but I really hate the fact how apparently everyone who wears this hat looks like they are they would be bald. Yeah. Well, I guess I just sell this, even though it's not worth much, but whatever.
Yeah.
And what about here?
I can do that. That's settled.
Ah, lots of crafting materials and copper. Valda's mausoleum. Let's have a little peek here. And more backers' names. This mausoleum has been sealed tight. Not this vault, though. Oh. Arbalest and a peridot and golden soil, which is worth 9 copper, even though there's so many 6 of it. Weird. All right, let's go inside this crypt and see what's going on there. Maybe there is a key to this place. Might be a bit too good to be true and too convenient considering how close they are to each other. But hey, it's possible. Oh. Ah, so here are the the Crucible Knight novitiate, and there is a ghost or wraith or bane or whatever named Lyra. Lyra, however you spell it. And a couple of and very interesting looking tomb, which I bet is full of riches, and a lone jar over there. Well, let's see what's going to happen. A woman turns when you enter. Her white pale eyes shine like lamps in the darkness of the tomb. Four crucible knights hover nearby, their glazed expressions fixed on her. Reinforcements at last. I hope you have come armed, because we have got to get out of here. Something about her seems hazy and insubstantial, even in the darkness of the tomb. So wait. Reinforcements at last. I hope you have come armed, because we have got to get out of here. So wait, was it the Crucible Knights who said that, or this ghost thingy here? I'm not sure. Well, whatever. I hate to be the one to tell you this, but you're already dead. Oh, alright, so it was Lyra, but she apparently thinks she's still alive. Who are you? What are you doing here? You don't fool me, Spectre. Should I just attack her? What are these soldiers doing here? She looks at them, but either she doesn't notice their distant gazes and the way they sway on their feet, or she thinks nothing of it. They are under my command, of course. They heard my call, and we have been waiting on a few more to help us fight our way out of here. I think something may be wrong with them. How did they manage to hear you in this tomb? Well, I don't really care about that. You don't fool me, Spectre. Lyra raises her arms to the swaying soldiers. Knights, attack! Well, looks like we have to kill these poor justiciors. Let's see. I guess you go there, tank those, while Palagina and I go here. And you, are you already going to use your spell, alright. And you, buff everyone quickly. And you, mark this one and send it to mark there. And I think we are settled. Oh, holy shit! Holy shit, we are. This hurts a lot. Use the Holy Radiance. What is this anyway? Current action. Okay. Oh, you're paralyzed? Oh, shit. I don't know. Shit, we are paralyzed. Well, this is fucking unfair, if you ask me. We need a strong healing spell here. Let's see, what do we have here? Nope. Well, let's try this, see what happens. Holy crap! Holy shit. Oh wait, did one of these Crucible Knights fall? Well, that's something, I guess. But we are down, that's not good. And you use this spell. Hey. Holy crap, and Palagina went there as well. Missing centuries. Well, thanks for the update. We are so fucked. We are so fucked. Use this on that one. We are so fucked. I don't want to use this because it's friendly fire. Well, use Ray of Fire. Can you do anything else, please? This is a bit too small. Oh yeah, why didn't I use this from the beginning? This is so damn cool. Cool, but he's paralyzed. God damn it! quickly, heal yourself. We might survive from this. We just might. Oh wait, where is the bouncing? There it is. And again. Or should I use the shock spell? Well, let's fucking try. Wow, that's fucking cool. I don't think we can survive this. And I don't even have any potions on him or anything. We are so fucked. I just realized that I'm really relying too much on my healing spells and such to keep my guys alive. I really should have gone to buy some healing potions from somewhere. Well, I'll keep that in mind next time. Yeah, we are so fucked here. Well, let's see how long we can last here.
How may I help?
Lava,
get your butt!
Fuck. Yeah. We have lost. Let's try again. Alright, now let's think about this some more.
I'm ready.
Maybe I should eat something. Let's see, what do you have? You got some food, and what did this give again? Plus 10 max endurance, might and perception. Well, I guess we should give you some pie then. And I have maximum endurance and constitution. Yep, I like that. And you guys don't really have anything. Oh, then there is this. Endurance and might. Say, what it might do again exactly? Wait, why can't I... for some reason I can't read the tips of these stats here. But I can read it here. Oh. There we go, I didn't need to click them. I should have been more patient. Oh wait. So let's see, I might. Spiritual strength, brute force, as well as the ability to channel powerful magic. Alright, so might can be useful on spellcasters as well, so you take this. Any good potion of minor regeneration? Who could use it the most? Well, I guess you could use it the most, like, or... Let's... Oh wait, you already full of these things? Minor endurance? Let's just give... Well, Palatina doesn't have almost anything, so you're gonna have this potion. She's our frontline anyway, so she needs it the most. Constitution. What did this do again? Oh, it's basically more tankiness. Alright, let's have a quick... Let's eat and drink.
Just
quickly.
Say the word.
Alright, hey. And then... And you... Eat this steak.
I'm ready.
Drink that.
I'm ready.
And eat some pie. Nice.
How may I help?
You eat some steak.
What?
And you don't need anything because you have...
Ready, Watcher.
And you don't have anything either, but this should be good enough. What is this? Oh, wait. You cannot do the... You can't use this because it's... Oh, yeah, that's not a trap. It's a scroll. What am I doing? Where is the trap? Well, I guess you can have this as well. Well, alright. I think we are good to go. Oh, wait. What? This fruit. I just give endurance. Not too useful for Zagani, I'm afraid. But, hey, that's something. And potion of minor recovery. Okay. Alright, let's try again. Alright, You don't fool me, Spectre. Now then, you go and tank those. In the meanwhile, We go fuck this one guy up very fast with Palagina and myself. And we buff everyone quickly, and you try to actually maybe we should just try to focus on them down very fast, one by one. We just nuke them down one by one. That sounds like a good plan. Eder, where are you? Oh, you are there. Well, maybe you should try to tank this ghost here. Let's see, what if I do this? Oh wait, I can't do it anymore. Fuck it. Anything that I can do to... Use it there. This doesn't look too good, but let's see what we can do. Oh, what was this? Ah, scrolling, rolling flame. Alright. I just want you to buff everyone. Let's see, what does this do? Deponent blows. Nagging doubt in the face of unbreakable fate consumes enemies in the area of effect, lowering their melee accuracy and critical hits range. This actually sounds very nice.
Hey! I can't move!
Holy crap! Look at this. We just lost like everyone lost like half of their endurance in a fucking seconds. In like instantly. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Actually, try to heal Aelod if you can. Oh wait, what is this? Well, this might actually be good, so use that. And I guess I should try to lead... Oh wait, what did this do again? Oh, all right, but this is the one that gives us endurance. So let's use.
Just say the word.
And Zagani is in deep trouble. So far, so good, I think. Use your Pillars of Justice on that spell on these three. And you have already used your knockbacks. You can use your Horrify spell or whatever that was on these two.
But this thing isn't doing the job.
And I guess you should... Oh wait, did you have anything? Well, you might as well use this. Durance is not doing very well. Try to heal him fast. And what else can we do here? Use it on these three. Oh wait, you're paralyzed. Well, that's fucking wonderful. Then try to use this when you can. And Durance is down, of course. These guys haven't lost like almost any health at all whatsoever. Jesus Christ. Well, at least one of them. Oh, wait, no. None of them has fallen. I don't think. My plan of focusing on one of them and try to nuke them down one by one and as fast as possible didn't seem to work.
Hey.
Or the execution was just fucking terrible.
That's not very helpful.
Ah! this is not going to work, is it? Yep, no. Let's reload. Alright, let's try this again. And this time I even placed two traps on the floor here. And everyone has eaten at least something, so now we should have
just say the word.
Better chances. Let's see. Alright, bitch, come at me. Now, for starters, you... Oh wait, not you. You buff everyone. And try to mark this one. And Palutena, you come somewhere around here. You use your this spell on these two, I guess. And then knock this one down. Oh, Jesus Christ, I can't see where everyone is because of all this light crap here. Go and attack this one, and you attack that one as well. And this time attack the same target so you can deal as much damage as possible. And you can at least... Which one was the one that was marked? You know, it would help me a lot if the game showed me which one was the one I marked. Well, anyway, attack that one, I don't know. What if we focus Leira as fast as... What if we focus her? Would that help? And he lost over half of his endurance instantly. That's so cheap. Just use your fucking spell already.
Love.
There we go. Use that there, and Palutena, can you try to heal Durant real fast? Jesus Christ, look at all these fucking injuries. I bet it's because of her. At least he's about to die, that's something. Let's see, what else? Oh, Firebrand. Oh yeah, this is the... I don't remember why do we have this. I think it was because of some weapon that we have. Well, whatever, use that. Why didn't I notice that earlier? Who had the potions and shit? Didn't you have them? No, but, well, use this. Yeah, look at us. Holy crap, that fuck sword is fucking cool. I don't know, use this. Who's the... Use that on that one. Halo is down, wonderful. Knock that one down quickly.
You got Sagani.
Fuck. And of course you're too slow. Fuck! This is so cheap. Yeah! Oh, I'm just terrible. These enthralled Justicars just won't go down. Yeah, none of them went down. None of them.
Love.
Yeah, this is so much bullshit. Change of plans, folks. This time we focus everything on this layer up bitch here. And maybe, just maybe, if we can kill her fast enough, these guys will come back to normal from being enthralled by this fucking ghost inspector here. So let's try that. Everyone, focus,
just say the word.
Focus on Leira. Fuck everything else.
I'm on it.
Yeah, come here, bitch. But I first want her to come here. You can buff everyone here for starters. And this time you mark her. And you can send it to mark there already.
Yes.
This won't hold me for long!
There we go, she's here. Now everyone focus on her, but you use this. And then you use this. You're gonna use this, right? And what, by the way, what are these? If only I knew I had these here too. Eder can still focus on these enthralled. Just this yours. Oh wait, where are you? You are there. What? Bears enemies' combat vulnerabilities for all to see, reducing their damage reduction, deflection, and concentration. Yeah, this. I should have used this a fucking long time ago, since the very beginning. Focus on that bitch. Itumak is stuck there, of course he is. I don't know, can you? There we go. Free allies in the area of effect from perceived constraints granted immunity to hobbled and stuck afflictions. I don't think that's going to help to paralyze him though. Yeah, this is very nice as well. Use that. And you use this on as many people as you can.
Can't move.
Yes, Leira is fucking dead. Fuck yes, she's fucking dead. She was actually a lot easier to take down than I thought. But now taking down the rest of these Justiciars here should be a lot easier because she's not there debuffing and paralyzing us all the time. Why didn't I do that earlier? Well, she's dead now and that's what matters. Punch that one in the face. And I guess you... I think they are fine, but maybe it's better that I go there and help them, just in case. Yeah, they come fast now.
I shot deep.
I really like that fiery sword effect we have on us right now. That's so fucking badass.
That's not very helpful.
Go ahead, fuck him up. Come on, die. Fuck yes! Fuck yes! This went so beautifully now. Only because I focused on that Spectre. Crucible plate armor. Interesting. Yep. Take everything. And I just wanna check out what does this look like. It looks rather poor compared to this what we are wearing already. Kind of disappointing, really. Maybe Eder could use it, but let's see. Damage reduction 12. Coral 15 crash pierce. This might actually be better just because it has slash, pierce, and shock there, but this has crush and corrode. Well, anyway, this has only like 2, and this has 3. Recovery speed minus 50%, minus 50%, fine, plus 2 damage reduction. Maybe if we enchant this some more. Yeah, let's enhance this. Enchant this, even. And let's give this to Eder. Yeah, he looks rather badass with this, I'm not gonna lie. Can we... Yes, we could. But I think I like this. What was it? I think it was this. Yeah, he looks nice with this armor. I still hate that door shield he has. It looks so dumb. But let's see. What about this? 16 deflection, 16 minus 8 accuracy, minus 8 accuracy. Fine, plus 4 shield deflection, grants bash. Oh, where is it? There we go. Did he really have bash? Or maybe I have missed his bash ability all this time just because it's not in the action bar, and directly. Just like our previous abilities, I didn't at first notice wasn't in her action bar. But whatever. I think I'm gonna hold on to the shield some more, because of that bash. Whatever it is, I should try to remember and try to actually freaking use it next time. But yeah. Now, let's see. Oh, and this was also the quest was also updated, if I recall. So let's see. I have dealt with Lyra, and she will no longer trouble the Crucible Knights or anyone else in Heritage Hill. I should go to Crucible Keep in the first fires and tell Willa what happened. Yeah, I do that.
I'm on it.
She's not going to be pleased by the fact that we killed all her guys, though. Well, one, because there's apparently one body here all of a sudden. Oh, wait. Before that...
Ready, Watcher.
I just want to be sure that it's not trapped or anything. Of course it's trapped! Of
Feels
course...
like I ate bad meat.
Of course it's trapped. But why didn't she... Well... I hate that noise it makes now. Well, anyway, I guess she didn't notice it because she doesn't have that high perception or trapped perceptions ability like Winky has. That could be it. Well, and it got absolutely nothing great.
Just
nothing,
say the word.
Nothing useful. Nothing useful at all. Potion of power. Plus 25% attack speed, plus 30 max endurance for 20 seconds. That actually sounds pretty fucking good. I think I'm gonna give that to myself. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. And more Kickstarter names, if I recall. Yep. Team 677 Sweeney. Thanks to the maker who thought that dreads the law of stories. Thanks to the goddess born from the maker's creation who renewed him. I vow as an unreal to live all stories as one. Well, alright. Well, let's just leave this place then. And explore the rest of the Heritage Hill. We have already explored about half of the place. And everyone seems to be mostly fine. Palatina is a bit hurt, but she should be fine. All right, and now everyone, fuck that one up. Except that you go and... Let's see. Where is your bash skill? It's not this one. That I know. Where is your bash skill? Or is it a passive? Oh wait, it's here. Oh, is it? Bash. It could be a passive thing. All right. Oh, and knock him down.
Hey.
Again. Come on, kill him. There we go.
I'm on it.
All right. Revenant. Now these are zombies. These are zombies. If I've ever seen one. Why didn't we just call them zombies? Well, whatever. Go and fuck them up. I don't know, somewhere around here, I guess. You just, I don't know, go just punch them in. Just hit them with your staff. This should do it.
Hey.
Oh, there's a ghoul there as well, alright.
Huh!
Those revenants sure were easy to kill. And that ghoul as well. Now what do we have here? Blood moss.
Leave it to me.
Crafting materials. And we are back here. Then we go this way. But first our tanks go first. More ingredients. Are we at the docks or something? Holy crap, this is going to be tough. I don't want to use knockdown on these ghouls because they are so weak. So focus on that dark ghoul. And I want you to buff everyone. At least the front line. God damn it, the Aelod is in the way. This should do a lot of damage. That's gonna be glorious. But now, you use this on everyone here. Beautiful. And what if I use this somewhere around here? That's gonna be fucking great. Let's see.
How may I help?
Nice. Oh crap. Oh, although I'm quite sure. I'm not sure if it was that spell that damaged Paladina and Durance or what. But whatever. I should try to be more careful. Oh wait, not that. This one. And you are there. Focus on that dog. Next. Holy crap, they're all going that way. Oh wait, no, use that. And you... That dark one is a problem, so... Use a ray of fire on that thing, and you... Shoot that. And Itumak is down, by the way. The fox. Knock that Darkhold down, and then we go and fuck that one up. You go and fuck that Darkhold up. And go and use your Ray of Fire on that one. And you just use this spell, and you... I guess we could mark... Oh wait, no, he's about to die anyway, just use this.
Just say the word! The enemy's over there.
Oh crap. One more.
There's a lesson to be taught.
There we go. But I think I should rest. We are all kind of beat up. And we have already used quite a lot of our spells and everything. And nothing but Vessel Flesh, of course, because that's what I've always wanted. And a simple rod, but that's not very good.
Yeah.
But let's explore some more, because I'm quite sure that there's not going to be any enemies here, down here anyway. And that's an entrance to tower, alright. And where was the place where we found the... Where was the location where we found that one camping supply, but we couldn't pick it up because we were already full. Whatever. I'll find it soon enough. But first, let's have a quick rest here. Yeah, this should be fine. Oh. You awake to see Durance, his staff held in both of his hands before him. A flame flickers at its top end, casting long shadows across his face as he stares in contemplation. Still, for all the light of the fire, your eyes can't focus on him. Perhaps it is awakening from sleep or a trick of the light, but he seems distinct, blurred from around the edges, everything except for the staff. The staff seems to be studying its engravings as you watch. The engravings glow thinly red, like through the cracks of heat suffused wood. The lines stream like molten metal, burning along the edges of his staff, then branch out in an intricate series of fiery veins, bunching thickly where his hands clutch the wood, pulsing as if a heartbeat. As you watch, the veins spiral into a dozen separate circles that spiral again until they are arranged in a circle of their own. They pulse, wait, and all is strangely silent, and then suddenly there is a great light from the fire, a rushing of air, a great flash, and you awaken again to see Durant in the same place, still holding his staff, but he is solid, real. He doesn't seem to have noticed you or reacted to what occurred. And I guess we got to have a little chat with him. Thought I felt your eyes on me. Now come the words. I had questions I wanted to ask you.
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
I saw something strange. You were sitting by the fire and I saw a great light from your staff.
Tell me what you saw.
Durant is silent, staring at your locking gazes. It was a flash like an explosion, a rushing of air, incredibly bright.
It is the light of the Godhammer you saw.
Ah, the Godhammer. In case you don't remember, Godhammer was that big bomb that was used in the Sins War to blow up that guy whose name escapes me. But I think he claimed to be some sort of a reincarnation of Aethys or something along those lines. The Godhammer?
It was a weapon of Deerwood's people.
Yeah, that.
A symbol of their independence. It saved the Deerwood.
Mm-hmm. What do you know about it?
It brought the Saints' War to an end. Knocked a god from his perch. There are few that would deny Aethys overstepped. The Godhammer reminded Aethys of it.
Mm-hmm.
You saw its light because I helped shape it. Give it life, and release it into the world. Once seen, its glory is almost too bright to be believed, and too bright to be forgotten.
You helped build the Godhammer?
There were 12 of us. We fashioned the weapon, drafted plans for it, prayed for guidance at Ashfall, and it came to me there. Each of us were given a staff made from the forest of black trees around us, glowing with embers and fire far greater than this branch you see now. It felt as if the staff was Margrin's own finger, guiding my hand, guiding the other 11, the shadows of the 12 who had come to stand on the bridge to stop Aethys.
Shadows of the 12? I also saw a dozen bright circles emerging from your staff as well. Well, let's go with this one.
Even in that stand, there was a ritual to it. For the 12 that stood on the bridge, there were a dozen shadows cast, a dozen faithful of Margrin, her fiercest supporters and shapers of the Godhammer.
Mm-hmm. Durant rests the staff in front of him, and the flame atop it curls for a moment, the light flaring slightly. It splits into a ring of flames, one after the other, until a dozen is met.
As 12 held Aethys fast, we 12 unleashed our prayers and let the Godhammer fall.
Then it blossoms brightly, once and resumes its candle intensity. In the aftermath, their shadows seem sharper in the vicinity, as if they have edges, and you blink to clear your vision. Durant is still staring at the tiny candle-like flame, intently.
Shadows cast by the fire of the Godhammer, perhaps. We share their fate as well in time. Now the spine of the Deerwood is marked by the Godhammer. Marked by Margrin.
Durant frowns and moves his gaze from the staff. What do you mean, shared their fate?
Not all deaths come with stilled breath and stilled heart. Or other stilled passions beneath the waist. Some deaths come from silence.
Mm-hmm.
The connection we once shared with Margrin. After the light of the Godhammer, It was not the same. It was as if we'd lost our senses. And sense of purpose as well. Instead of victory, being welcomed, there was silence. Within and without. Not many can claim to have killed a god. It is less a heroic tale than you would think. And such a death, it changed our faith. All faiths, I expect. Doubt followed, and the world changed. I do not believe Margrin was pleased by what we had done.
And why is that?
The world is broken. The wheel stilled. There is sickness in the world's heart. Perhaps the price of crossing a god.
Mm-hmm.
Crossing two gods. Even as Margrin shaped our hands, perhaps we carried her will farther than was allowed. Just as Widewind did. Saint Widewind. Mortal arrogance to match mortal arrogance.
Oh yeah, it was Widewind was the guy who claimed to be Eltas or something along those lines in Saints War.
Yet if the world had changed, then I sought to change with it. If I had forgotten some of Margaret's teachings, I would find them again. I would make her see me again.
What did you do?
I remembered Margaret's teachings. How reminders on the flesh were more important than the death of a vessel. And I wondered if killing Aethys, if that had simply set him free. Had it allowed him to escape his punishment and be taken on the wheel? Like a mortal? As I stepped from the now blessed Godhammer Bridge, I thought of Ashfall. I thought of the War of Black Trees. Wondered if I needed to be burned to find myself again. That is Margrin at her heart. At least that is my hope. These are the doubts that befall me.
All right, and what happened? And what happened when you returned to Ashfall?
The road to Ashfall is long. Gives one time to think. If you think long enough, you do not go home. I left without telling anyone, with only the robes I wore at Halgott, my staff, and my name, which is long buried. Of my fellow 11 craftsmen, disciples, I knew not what happened to them, if they suffered the same doubt as I did. But it was underserved. It was wrong. He had done all that. Oh, had asked. Grabbed victory from defeat and...
You feel as if your god has betrayed you? Do you feel as if you betrayed your god? What was that sound? I don't know if you heard this, but once every once in a while I hear that some weird beeping and I have no fucking idea where it comes from. I really need to find a source and get rid of it. But anyway, you feel as if your god has betrayed you, or do you feel as if you betrayed your god? Well, yeah, this sounds perhaps more sensible considering what he has said.
There is something about being used and cast aside. Perhaps Widewind himself felt it. There at the end, when the hammer struck. To be the proof that your god is hollow as the vessel it inhabits. I tried to find purpose, and avoided all contact with other Magranic priests. Did not seek the walls of Ashfall, and sought to make amends to my god through actions. I joined with the purges for a time. And not long after, came the first signs of the Hollowborn. So many crimes, trespasses, violations. The Salvation. Animancers were another sickness born of the Saints' War. A relapse of innovation, of desperation to heal what we had caused. All seemed worse than before the breach, not better. And as years passed, the world became even worse still for the victory.
Maybe the purchase weren't what Makran wanted either. No, I see why you call your goddess a whore. She jilted you and you're still pined for. You committed atrocities and your goddess has shut you out of it. Exactly what you deserve. It doesn't sound like your goddess will ever forgive you. It would seem Makran's silence is your trial. Now I see why you call her your goddess a whore. She jilted you and you still pine for her. I like this. Sweat collects in the sooty creases of his forehead and runs down his ruddy cheeks. It drips from the tip of his nose. His mouth moves, but his utterances make no sound. He is, for once, at a loss. Feeling your gaze, he quickly composes himself, wiping his forehead with the back of a dirty hand.
Hmm? Worship the whims of some fickle bitch, and you'll never be more than dirt beneath her feet. Worship what she worships, on the other hand. Take her fire for your own, and her esteem comes on its own. Of course, by that time you no longer need it. Trial and transformation, sure as Durance taught.
Durance glares at you, and staring into his eyes gives you the feeling of peering over the edge of a great cliff.
You think to put the coals to my feet, but what's burned once will never burn again. These talks are your trial, Watcher. You cannot deflect the truth to one who has already been purified by it.
Right. I don't really care to ask about the God Hammer because we basically know what it is and what it did. Tell me what happened on the bridge. We chose the bridge because we could control it. Durance's hands tightened at the top of the staff, as if holding it by the neck. It was a place where we could choke Eothas in his own footsteps, where we knew his feet would fall, a narrow neck of stone. But it was more than that. It was the spine of the Deerwood, symbolic of its backbone. Such symbols are important in the construction of a weapon. Durance studies his staff, his eyes traveling along the etchings. Any weapon. Durance's face hardens and his eyes burn, his eyebrows narrowing. I suspect Eothas knew that as well, and so did his vessel, in its arrogance. His hand tightens on the staff. He intended to walk upon the bridge as if walking on the backs of the Deerwood. And we intended to burn him with the light of our fate, and his. 12 on the bridge, 12 in the shadow, and gave ourselves to it. Gave yourselves to it?
We put much of ourselves into the Godhammer. Such a device is not simply a machine. There are elements of the spirit in it. Even Widewind's spirit.
Elements of the spirit?
Each of the 12 who brought the Godhammer forth would have done anything to save the Deerwood, save its people. It is why we were chosen. Each of us hated this pretender. That rage, that spirit, that rebellion went into our work, and went into studying him as well.
Wait, when? Why?
We all studied Widewind.
Widewind.
He was our enemy, and he had provided the flesh the god wore as a cloak. That flesh made him vulnerable. I knew what fields his hands had tilled, his family, what he had harvested, where he had been born. We sought to know him, what had led him to fight us.
Man, why was that important?
You don't kill the god. You kill the man it inhabits. And you leave that man a ruin. Burn him to ash. The weapon was meant to not only burn his flesh, but it would burn his soul. And it did. At the cost of our own. And at the cost of our goddess's favor. That whore be damned.
It sounds as if you fell victim to your own weapon. Is that why your image was blurred in the dream? Is that why your image was blurred in the dream? Durance frowns, glances at you with a sharp look. Perhaps your eyes were blinded by the Godhammer's light, Watcher. He snorts. I may feel half a man at times, but even that is twice that of most others.
If you fear for my spirit, your fears are baseless. The Godhammer, seeing its light, only fueled my anger and made me stronger. Made me re-examine the teachings of Margrin. Put them in a new light.
It looked as if there was only part of you, as if your spirit had been shared in half.
I do not need you to cast any more questions on me, Watcher. Nor did I ask you to look upon me without my leave. Get gone, and leave me be.
Well, fine, be like that. Continue to get to know Durance, all right. Now then, what was I supposed to do now? Oh yeah, yeah. I was just wondering that. Oh wait, no. God damn it.
Just say the word.
I thought I was Sagani for a moment. But anyway, yeah. Where was that item or that place where we found the extra camping supplies? Because I would like to pick that up now since we got some room. Let's see. It was somewhere around here, I'm quite sure. Wait, maybe it's even here. No. Where is it? I would like to find that, and then I think I'm gonna stop the episode. And I can't go there, still. Oh wait, it's here, wasn't it? Yeah, it was here in this crate here, yeah. Now I remember. In that box, crate, whatever it is. Yeah, here it is. Okie dokie. And then, let's see what we have here. Let's have a quick peek here before we end this episode here for today. And I think I guess I should also go and explore this tower as well in next time. Well, more revenants. Well, this should be a piece of cake. Just go and shield bash them, and you go and attack that one. Yeah, you go do that one as well. Mark this one and send it to mark there. And you, I don't know, go and hit that one in the face with your staff. And you, let's see.
Hey, indeed.
There was a bit more than I expected, but shouldn't be a problem. And again. Yeah, piece of cake. They are dropping like flies. Yeah, no. Well, okay, Paladina got a tiny bit of hurt, but
just say the word.
But basically, no one really got hurt at all there. And looks like we can't.
Leave it to me.
They didn't drop even vessel flesh. Well, fine. Male coif, but there's and more camber supplies. All right, that's a nice find. We can pick it up, but hey, we can pick it up later once we have rested again at some point. But yeah, I think I'm going to end this episode here now. And in the next one, well, we are going to explore the rest of the Heritage Hill. Not that there's much left, but we are going to explore that some more. And I think this is a graveyard by the looks of it. And then we are going to possibly go and explore this tower here before we go back to Crucible Keep and basically complete these two quests we got from there. But yeah, that's what we are gonna do next time. Now then, thank you for watching once again, and see you next time for more Pillars of Eternity.